entire Black Enterprise team for having us. AT&T has been working with Black Enterprise all year on initiatives including the Women of Power Summit, the Entrepreneur Summit, but it was only fitting that we once again collaborate on the TECHCNXT Summit. I'd like to acknowledge some of my colleagues here from AT&T who are with us from across the country. Please briefly stand. Xavier Williams, Executive Vice President of Global Customer Service. Jennifer Jones, Vice President of Diverse Markets. Melissa Grant Anderson, Vice President of Workforce Development. We all know that technology is at the core of everything we do, from providing devices and services to spearheading the next big discovery through our many Foundry Innovation Centers, which some of you will have a chance to visit this week. AT&T is also committed to diversity and helping close the gap with African Americans in the tech industry. Not only do we support conferences like this and sponsor programming that is relevant to the African American community, but we also seek to mentor, hire, and promote talented African Americans who will help us to advance our business objectives and society. In fact, African Americans make up nearly 20% of AT&T's U.S. workforce, and we've won a number of awards in the area of diversity and inclusion. We're very proud of the initiatives and the impact our company demonstrates in this area. Our talent acquisition team cast a wide net to ensure we are receiving diverse students from all across the country. We partner with organizations like BBYA, the Society of Black Engineers, and our HBCUs to reach the best and brightest technical talent. In fact, AT&T recently sponsored the nation's football classic in Washington, D.C., a football match between two historically Black universities, Hampton University, and my law school alma mater, Howard University.
You're in Santa Fe, California.
Sponsoring the nation's football classic is a great way to engage the community and the student bodies of these schools. But this year, we decided to increase our commitment and actually bring students from both Howard and Hampton to this tech conference. There's no better teacher than experience, and AT&T is dedicated to providing access and experiences to the next generation of African American engineers, executives, and entrepreneurs. I am confident that the future president of AT&T California may sit right here in this room today. Are you here? I invite you to visit the Digital Lounge daily that AT&T is hosting, and also don't miss the Tech Talk tomorrow, featuring renowned music producer and engineer Young Guru, where he will speak on the intersection of music and technology. I look forward to connecting with many of you, and I hope you will enjoy these dynamic sessions. Have a fantastic next couple of days.
Now, please welcome to the stage Senior Vice President, Executive Editor at Large, Black Enterprises, Ed Alfred Edmond.
My great pleasure to be here at the first ever Black Enterprise TECHCNXT Summit. Let's give another round of applause to Tom Moore and Ken McNeely. So I've been hyped for this for like months, this conversation we're about to have. I get to moderate the discussion, Investing in Millennial Tech Stars. So without further ado, let me introduce you to our panelists who will be engaging in this discussion too, just amazing, amazing people. First, we have Jim Draper, the founder of Draper Associates. He founded the company in 1985 and was joined by John Fisher and Steve Jurvetson and became venture capital firm Draper Fisher Jurvetson, now DM.